Does that not make you nervous at all?
No, it's a movie.
But the horse. But the horse is real.
Yeah, you can die.
In just three movies, John Wick kills some 299 goons. 77 in the first one, 128 in the second one, and 94 in Chapter 3. If you stumbled across that many bodies in an open field, you'd be horrified. But the magic of action movies is you forget about all those nameless dead people the moment they vanish from the screen. But I didn't forget, and their loved ones definitely didn't forget. So let's use math to shatter your convenient amnesia and explore the horror experienced by the victims' families. Hooray! For starters, the John Wick universe may be full of shadowy cabals of elite assassins, but the real power is consolidated in the funeral industry. After all, the majority of John's slaughter takes place in New York City, where the good people at Choice Mutual say the average funeral costs $6,841. And that's just the service. There's also the plot and the headstone to consider. I mean, dying is expensive, which is why I recommend never dying. But if you get in John Wick's way, even a bumpy piece of land near the budget cemetery's ugly maintenance shed will probably cost your bereaved loved one at least $700, and a basic headstone that only has room for beloved father and sick headshot victim will be another $300. Multiply $7,841 by 299 victims, and suddenly John has generated $2,344,459 in funeral costs. And yeah, maybe some of the less popular goons could just be rolled into a ditch, but it all averages out once the wife of henchman number 117 decides that her special husband needs a hilltop view guarded by a stone angel for all eternity. Speaking of mourning loved ones, in 2019, Pew Research found that half of Americans over 18 are married, and another 7% are cohabitating long-term. 57% of 299 gives us about 170 grieving partners, to say nothing of nascent relationships and casual flings left wondering why they're suddenly being ghosted. Possibly literally. And of course, we have to think of the children. The 2019 census determined that 61.6% of American men over 15 are fathers, not counting the results of the drunken one-night stands you would absolutely indulge in if you were a gunman in a world where John Wick tears through your profession like a hot knife through butter that's too dumb to learn from all the other sticks of butter that came before it. Furthermore, the average family with children has 1.93 of them, leading to a staggering 355 kids who will grow up without a father thanks to Wick's scorched earth policy. Oh, and while single parenthood is still largely the domain of women, 8% of households with minors are headed by single men, and 8% of 355 gives us about 28 orphans, which is depressing, but does make me wish for a movie where they team up to get revenge on John. Now, it's a little tough to determine the average age of John Wick's victims because we see most of them for about half a second before their heads explode, but they typically look older and somewhat experienced, more like security guards or private military contractors than fresh-faced army recruits. And so, you know, if the average security guard is 41.9 years old and PMCs tend to be in their mid-30s to early 40s, let's go ahead and say that Wick's victims average out to about an even 40. The average American male's life expectancy is 78.54 years, unless they encounter John Wick, at which point 38.54 years are abruptly cut from their lives. That means that Wick has exterminated a collective 11,523.46 years of potential human life that could have been spent with loving families, if only Alfie Allen hadn't killed that damn dog. Even worse, if we assume they were hoping to retire from this business of misery at the average retirement age of 65, then that's 25 years of prime money-making potential gone per victim. And if we combine the average $27,280 annual salary of a security guard with military contractors' $61,955 annual salary, and multiply that average by 25 lost years, and again by 299 people who can't work anymore, you know, because of their deadness, we get a freaking staggering $333,515,812.50 in lost earnings their families will never see. And even that feels a little low because these guys are all tied to organized crime and they're all wearing these really nice suits that are just, you know, perfect for blood spatter. But it's not all doom and gloom because at least half the victims' orphans and the other loved ones will be reasonably compensated because 54% of Americans have life insurance. And I know, does your profession run the risk of encountering John Wick is probably a standard question in this universe that spikes premiums into the stratosphere. but this is also a universe where a secret underground bureaucracy oversees the hitman economy. So let's assume that they have a few agents planted in the highest offices of Geico to keep rates stabilized. Anyway, as of 2018, the average American life insurance policy had a value of $168,000. Well, 54% of 299 goons rounds down to 161 responsible goons thinking of their children's future, which means their deaths are paying out a collective $27,048,000 to their surviving relatives. It's not exactly enough to cover the cost of their loss, but if the families pooled their resources, that's more than enough money to buy a gently used 190-foot super yacht for the vengeful orphans to train on. Oh my God, it's all coming together. All of this grieving and paperwork is why action movies encourage you to live in the moment, especially when that moment contains an awesome explosion. So I hope you all take a moment to reflect on how pop culture deadens us to the horrifying human cost of violence. And then I'll see you guys in theaters for John Wick Chapter 4.